having me.
Did you have any trouble finding the Barrow building?
That's a personal matter and I'd rather not answer that.
Okay. Shall we get started with the interview then?
Sometimes.
Okay. So let me start by telling you how this university differs from others in the state. We're a smaller school with smaller class sizes and personal attention, but we have the resources of a big state school. These resources include amazing internships and a faculty practicing professional.
Well, I'm glad to hear that. When I applied in state, one of my biggest fears was being overwhelmed by huge lecture classes.
That's exactly the type of atmosphere we tried to avoid here. Now, have you thought about your major yet?
That's my mother you're talking about here! Oh dear, you didn't just ask to see my mother in a two-piece bathing suit, did you?
No, I didn't.
Allow me to explain. I have this extremely rare disorder known as cornaquistigmatis. It's a neurological condition that renders a person incapable of seeing a question correctly.
And by correctly, you mean?
Every time you ask a question, I hear a completely different one.
I see. How come I've never heard of cornaquistigmatis thing before?
Eleanor Roosevelt, probably. Sorry, I should have told you as soon as I came in. I just don't like to make a big deal out of it.
Well, Harriet, I don't know what I can do exactly. A college interview is primarily the asking of questions.
So, if a deaf person came in, you just refuse to do the interview?
No, I would make sure that a translator fluent in sign language was available to aid in the interview.
Well, I'm sorry that the AMA hasn't recognized CQM as a legitimate medical condition, but I try to live my life in a normal and healthy way, and I would appreciate it if you'd treat me as any other prospective student.
I guess, but, well, okay, shall we just continue with the interview then?
It's in Argentina, isn't it?
So, what extracurricular activities are you interested in?
Marcus Block, 7th grade. We both had braces. It was kind of awkward.
Okay, what's your favorite subject in school?
I would take South Pike Road, except during rush hour.
What's your favorite color?
Every Sunday.
Is it just me or is this completely pointless?
I don't know too much about the salivary gland. I don't take bio, sorry.
Okay, well, Harriet, thanks so much for coming by.
Thank you.
Do you need any directions to get back on I-20?
Cookie Monster? I guess I just like the goggly eyes. Is that weird?
A little, yeah.
I never played sports in school, but I played in a number of rec leagues. Basketball, volleyball, soccer. I volunteer monthly at a soup kitchen. I'm a practicing vampire. I'm sleeping at a sleepaway camp during summers. Is that what you were looking for?
Yeah, definitely. I'm sorry. Can you elaborate a little bit more on...
On the soup kitchen, of course. Actually, I got into it because of my parents. They were really big into community service.
I'm sorry. It sounded like if you said you were a practicing vampire.
Oh, yeah. Pretty much my whole life.
Okay. So you think you're a vampire?
Oh, no. That would be... That's not quite...
Oh. Okay, I'm sorry. I guess I'm just a little...
I'm a practicing vampire. It's completely different.
So is this like a club or role-playing game?
No, it's more serious than that. Basically, I live my life in preparation that someday I will hopefully turn into a vampire. Right, so I sleep in a coffin, avoid garlic, eat lots of bloody meat, chew with my fans, all in the hopes that one day, if I'm diligent enough, I will turn into a vampire.
I see. So then why are you here now? I mean, shouldn't vampires not be out in the daylight?
Oh, that's a common stereotype. Vampires, just like humans, can walk freely in the sunlight without even the slightest irritation to the skin.
Right. So you're kind of like one of those twilight vampires.
Is this an attempt of humor?
No.
Because I do not find this funny at all. Actually, I find that pretty insulting, and to be totally honest, pretty vampirist.
Vampire? Listen, there's no such thing as vampire.
Excuse me? That's the most offensive thing I've heard. I am going to leave now.
Is this some kind of joke? Did someone put you up to?
No, this is very serious. And when I get a hold of the NBUA, you are going to have a public relations nightmare on your hands.
The NBUA?
National Vampires Union, wahaha. All vampires should be respected and given blood to.
All right. Well, you go call the NBUA and say hi to Dracula and Lestat and all those whiny Twilight kids for me.
Sure, I will, because we are all just the same to you. Honestly, I expected so much more out of this university.
Union for vampires?
And the whole audience is completely drenched.
Oh man, wow!
Needless to say, that was the last time I've ever been to SeaWorld.
Well then, I have to tell you, everything looks great. Your grades, recommendations, and your GPA is high above school's average. And your essay, it was so moving.
You know, this is such a great university. I'd be honored to attend.
Hey, we'd be lucky to have you. Are you applying to any of the schools?
Nope, just here.
Oh, okay. Great, great.
So?
Yes?
I'm in then?
Well, no. I have to give this over to my supervisors and then they'll... It's a process, you know. I can't officially...
Sit down. Sit down.
Is there a problem?
Well, that depends on you. You see, for reasons I can't entirely explain right now, it is essential that I attend this university. I've been meticulously planning for this day. Years of SAT prep, AP classes, all in the hopes of being accepted. I was intending of hearing an answer today.
Well, I'm sorry. I don't have the authority to just let you in today.
They are forces, friends. Forces you cannot possibly comprehend. But trust me, it is very vital, not only for me, but for the entire student body and faculty, that I'm enrolled in the next fall semester. Many lives hang in the balance. You don't want to be held responsible for the loss of lives, do you?
Of course not, but how is me letting you in going to save lives?
You see, the world is a series of connections and plans. Every human being affects another. Every decision has a consequence. And this decision, trust me, this decision will be the most important you'll ever make.
Ben, you're being incredibly vague, and besides, it's just not as simple as me letting you in.
An oral agreement is legally binding in this state, so in fact, it is that simple.
Look, what I can tell you is that it's basically a done deal. I'm going to give you a great recommendation, and with your staff...
That's not what I was hoping to hear.
Ben, let's not ruin what was a great interview by...
I'm not leaving until I get my answer.
Well, you're going to have to, because I have another appointment coming in at 1.
No, you don't. Your 1 o'clock meeting canceled this morning, so the only one afterwards is Rebecca Smith at 4:45.
How did you... Did you break into my email or something? Okay, I'm not entirely sure what's going on right now, but I'm going to have to call... Security. Hello? Hello? Hello?
Phone troubles.
Oh my.
Door's locked.
Oh, and we're 10 stories up, so the windows wouldn't be a safe option either.
All right. Who are you?
Her name is but a label, and I have many labels, but that's not important right now. What's important is that you tell me exactly what I was expecting to hear today.
Then if I could, I would. It's just...
It's just an outage, my friend. Circuits break all the time.
Please, I don't have any real authority. An acceptance from me would be meaningless.
Then there's no reason not to say it.
Why are you doing this?
I'm not doing this. You're doing this. And it could all be over with those three little words.
But it won't.
No! Those are not the right words! Say it! Just say it!
Oh man, that's great! Oh god! Oh, I can't tell you how. Oh, I gotta call my mom. Thank you so much. It was so nice to meet you. Thank you.
Thank you to Tad, who built this one, and thank you to all my actors.